You're coming?
Just turn it on.
Oh yeah, that's
that was nothing. This is fun.
My little things are for the young man. Why the stage?
You stopped on me.
I'm sorry.
I was here on it.
Oh my God.
Just push the right button.
Beverage at this intermission time, ladies and gentlemen. It's fine. Get some chips. Some little snacks. It's fine. I don't know if they have snacks. But you can find them. It's fine. Our entertainment will be back here just in a second.
Intermission.
How about you demonstrate the stripper pole?
Don't stop believing!
Wrong song!
Yay! Give a hand for young man boy. Yay!
Did you just call him a man boy?
Yeah, sure.
You're so mean.
I know, right?
Well, that's fun. Wasn't I like right in the middle of threesomes and just kind of... That's cool. So anyway, let's just finish that one real quick, okay? Can you imagine dating a guy and what he wants is a threesome because you're not about to take it up the ass? And you have to call your friend and say, listen, I really need you to have sex with me and my fuck buddy, or I have to take it up the ass. And she says, I've got your back, let's do this. That's a keeper. You never know when that friend is going to come in handy, okay? So, let's be honest. I am not a multitasker, so threesomes are not really my thing. Can't focus on more than one thing at a time. And there is a... So you can't, like... I mean, you're breathing and laughing.
Yeah.
Pushing them. Ooh, push it. Sorry, that was out there. Anyway, so, but with threesomes, there's a lot that you have to focus on. Like, there's a bunch of, like, rubbing, and there's touching, and licking, and poking, and it's a lot to handle. But as an adult, I feel like I probably shouldn't complain, because most likely that's what a little boy feels like every time he goes to confession. You just hear, like, the... What? It's okay. You guys are all going to hell with me. It's fine. Get on the bus. Why not? On it! I have a knack for hitting on people that don't want me. I feel like the entire night is just going to be like, right here. Somehow I end up getting guys that don't like girls. And I don't figure that out until it's too late. So, there are always a lot of signs leading up to this event. But it really solidifies it when, you're actually sleeping with somebody and, they can't hit the right hole to save their life. Do you guys know what the flipper is? The flipper is when a guy is taking a girl from behind And he hits the wrong hole, and she goes, Amy! 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 Dolphins in the Atlantic could hear me, I'm sorry. They couldn't help me, though. So we finally, you know, we get done, and we're starting to get dressed, and I turn the lights on, and he is now wearing my panties. Oops, sorry, thought they were mine. They are now. Sorry. I think I was more upset about the fact that he looked better in them than I did.
No.
He pulled that shit off well. It just happens. So we have, what was it? Janice already asked. We've got people with kids, right? Kids? Yeah. Woo. I have a kid too. He's 8. And he is in this mode where he is asking all kinds of questions that I am not prepared to answer. So there was one day that we had just had a very trying day where he's asking all of these things, and then we get to a restaurant. It's a very quiet restaurant. And he says, Mom, what's a cock? And in my frustrated point, I looked at him, and I was like, it's a penis. It's a penis, and a penis goes in a vagina, and that's how a baby is made. Are you happy? Does that answer your questions? But it just looks like a rooster here. Fucking Chinese zodiac. And now he has all kinds of questions because he thinks that a rooster is involved in making a baby. That's great. What do you do? He's actually a redhead too. So I'm trying to prepare him for what life is about to bring him. And, just got a bunch of giggles already. What is the number one question that a redhead is asked?
Are you red down there, too?
Do the carpets match the drapes?
Yeah, yes. Yeah, I remember that.
Yes. Is it supposed to be purple? Like, does it change with my mood? I don't get it. I don't understand. I think one of the first times that I was asked that question, I was like, probably late junior high. And he was like, do the carpets match the drapes? And I was like, I don't have any carpet. Swear to God, he about came in his 14-year-old pants. Little did he know I had yet to hit puberty. So I just did not have carpet. Redhead stereotypes, right? Right?
Yeah.
What is it? We have very violent tempers. We're just angry in general. I'm going to hear that we're good in bed. I hear this.
I'm hearing something coming there.
And also, I mean, I don't know about the rest of you, but I can hold a grudge like none other. Which is funny, because I get cheated on. And I'm like, really? If you're going to cheat on me, guess what's going to happen? I am probably going to beat the shit out of you. I am probably going to take all of your belongings and burn them in my yard. I might fuck your best friend. And number 4, I'm going to get a cat. You want to know why I'm going to get a cat? I'm going to get a cat, I'm going to name it after you. I'm going to get a cat and name it after you so I can forever say that you're a fucking pussy. Thanks, guys. I'm Tiffany Benjamin. Have a great one, all right?
Let's get a big round of applause for Tiffany. And let's keep it going for this beautiful facility and the staff that runs it. We got beer back there, guys. It's good. It's cold. You might as well get on some of it. Anyway, I neglected to point out some of the celebrities that we have in the audience. I'm going to go around and introduce some of them to you. Ladies and gentlemen, Courtney Cox over here. She's here with Willie Robertson. This table here is the real honor. Mel Gibson. Yeah. Alfred Hitchcock. Jerry Garcia. Yeah. And ladies and gentlemen, American legend, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Right here we got Flavor Flav. How about it for you, everybody? That's what I'm talking about. That's the kind of energy you're going to need to keep up for your next comedian. Ladies and gentlemen, this guy has opened for Preston Lacey of the Jackass movies. Ladies and gentlemen, Fairfield's own, the Jack Black of Southeast Iowa, Jeffy Alexander. Brad Pitt, ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Brad Pitt. That doesn't sound accurate at all. Let me rephrase that. Ladies and gentlemen, Brad Pitt, who has just been attacked by a bunch of bees, ladies and gentlemen, make some noise. No, seriously, Dave Johnson, today is Dave Johnson's birthday, all right? He is 49 years young. He's helped me a whole bunch with his comedy stuff. Please make some noise for that guy. Come on. I know what you're thinking when you see him, but I've done a ton of shows with him, and let me tell you guys what, that guy slays the ladies, okay? He slays some pussy, okay? I think this would be funnier if I don't list, okay? That guy slays the ladies, alright? He slays some pussy, he slays them. And by slays, I mean he does it Game of Thrones style, okay? You guys like Game of Thrones, heard of that? Sir, do you do it Game of Thrones style? No? Good, because you're not going to be mad at me. Game of Thrones, here's how you do it Game of Thrones style. Most of the time, it's not really all that consensual. Most of the time, there's a dwarf involved. And more often than not, it's with his own sister. So, happy birthday, Dave! Skeet! My name is Jeffy Alexander, and I'm up here representing all the men with sexy dad bods. That's what I'm doing. I gotta worry. Please do not mistake my sex fat for love handles, though, okay? I don't just give it away. But I will let you guys gaze upon my sexy man meat for 3 seconds uninterrupted. Go for it. That's all you get. That thing that amazes me. That's the big thing in Hollywood right now. Is sexy dad bods. I never thought, like men who are just don't exercise and just let it go. That is the popular thing right now. And I say, if sexy dad bods are in, I'm Leonardo freaking DiCaprio, alright? But to be honest though, I really don't have a sexy dad bod. I really have more of a creepy Uncle Jimmy bod. You know, that uncle that you have in the family that you don't really talk about. But for some reason, you invite him to a family gathering once a decade, and he always reminds you why you banned him from the family in the first place. Hey, Dean. Hey, when are you gonna let your boys spend the night weekend at my house? I want to show him my basement full of jump houses and buttered popcorn. Get out! But it's all good. But anyway, my name is Jeffy Alexander, and I love it here in Fairfield. Thank you guys for coming out. It's been great. My wife, I got a beautiful wife, which surprises me too, so. Surprises the hell out of me. When we first started dating, I would take her out, and everybody would be like, is that your girlfriend? I'm like, yeah. They're like, why? I don't get it either. Oh, my girlfriend, though, my wife, though, she is a natural ginger, all right? It's the whole theme tonight, it's gingers. That's how we roll here. She's actually a natural ginger. She dyes her hair a lot, so you can't tell, but she's a natural ginger, and she bore me I've got a 15-month-old son named JJ. He's a ginger, too, so, yeah, so that makes me a ginger by proxy. Or a sexually transmitted ginger. an STG. I didn't realize she was a ginger when I first met her. We met at a rock show and she had that dyed red hair. And then we hooked up later and she gave me a hand job and I contracted freckles. At least I hope they're freckles. What did you do to me? But my son JJ, he's fantastic. He's great. He sleeps all night. He eats all the time. He's always happy. He doesn't cry a lot. The only thing the kid is missing is skin pigmentation and a soul. That is all he is missing. That is it. Okay? But here's the thing. JJ's one of six kids I have. I have six kids. Yes. I understand your silence. I get it. I should be working at like seven gas stations right now. I should be just getting off the Casey shift going straight to Come and Go. But I'm here. But that's the modern American family you see anymore. Because it's hers, mine, and ours. And that's my situation. It's hers, mine, and ours. And who here has been married for 10, 20, 30 years? Who's been married for a long period of time? You? Congratulations. God bless you. It is difficult to do these days. It really is. It's hard. And it takes a lot of work. So God bless you. I couldn't do it. I couldn't do it at all. I was married for 8 years to one woman. And married to one woman. Not polygamous. I was married to her for 8 years. But we actually broke up because of religious reasons, if you can believe it, okay? Because I'm Irish Catholic and she was a bitch, so it didn't work. She knows what she was. We get along now, but it's fine. But yeah, that's the modern American family. It's hers, mine, and ours. And anymore, the first marriage anymore is like renting a car. It's like you pull in and you fill out some paperwork and would you like the keys? I do. And you get the insurance on it. And then you eat in it, and then you smoke in it, and you drive it real fast, and you drive it off a cliff, and then you light it on fire! And then you pull it up to the curb, give it back to the people, and you go get yourself a younger, hotter model. That's funny to me, I don't know what you guys' freaking problem. But yeah, that's my situation. I had my first kid when I was 18 years old. And if you know, it's 2015 though. If I explain my situation like, I have six kids, you guys are like, holy shit, he has six kids. And then we leave it at that. If I would explain my situation 30, 40, 50 years ago, you would have looked at me sideways and maybe chased me out of town with pitchforks. Because my situation, if you explain it, my situation, I have my first child from my high school sweetheart, I have three kids from my first marriage, I have JJ, new little baby with my new marriage, I have a stepdaughter who I had no fun in making, but I still pay for and keep alive and shit. So if you take that down to the lowest common denominator, I have six kids between three women and a man. That is your modern American family, ladies and gentlemen. The Westboro Baptist Church, they picket my house, but they don't know what to put on their signs. One just stands there and says, God hates, fill in the blank. And then one says, I just think I should stand here. Burn, sinner! Here's the thing about my... I explained to you my son. Here's the thing about my little son. I love him very dearly. But you know what the shitty thing about that is? As if there could be a shitty thing. I had a vasectomy back in 2006. That gingery little cat's ride-off was supposed to be a four-wheeler. And trust me, I looked at my wife at the time when she told me she was pregnant. I'm like, what have you been doing? And my wife is the sweetest, yeah. My wife is the sweetest, nicest person you would ever meet. She loves everybody. She loves animals. But at that moment, she got ghetto angry. She's like, I've been climbing your fat white Mount Everest ass for 3 years, and only your fat Mount Everest ass for 3 years. You told me I wasn't having any more babies. What have you been doing, you lying sack of shit? Calm down, Tyler Perry. It's fine. But yeah, I was not supposed to have any more kids. dimension going on in my side of me, where my sperm was building a bridge out the backs of their dead brothers, found their way to the semen river, and made their way to the vagina homeland! Hallelujah, skeet skeet, motherfucker! When the sweat comes off my balls, all these bitches crawl. So I have to go have another vasectomy. And I don't want to, because the first one was no freaking picnic. Now I'm going to tell you that story, because I have the microphone, and I love talking about my balls. So I went to a pre-op appointment because the insurance can't have enough of my money. And they gave me a sheet of paper with all the instructions to do before the surgery. Now, I've never had a surgery before this point. I was 26, never had a surgery. And I'm not what you call a reader, but I remember the first thing it said on the top of that piece of paper was,